Hi, I'm Eric Schmidt with the League of Women Voters. With us today is John Verbeek. He is the Republican candidate for House District 34 in the Oregon House of Representatives. Mr. Verbeek, thank you for joining us today. Why don't you take a couple of minutes, tell us about yourself and why you're running for House District 34.
Thank you, Eric. I'm a naturalized United States citizen. I lived in Oregon in this house for decades. I'm married. We have three adult children, and I have a financial background, banking, insurance, and that makes me a cautious person. And once I became a citizen, I started running because I felt I didn't have any representation.
What would be the top two or three priorities that you would have if you're elected to House District 34 in the legislature?
Public safety, number one. Constitutional rights, number two. And the pursuit of justice, number three. And the public safety, to me, starts in the home, in the family. I like what the sheriff once said. He told the father of a disobedient son, either you spend time with him now, or I will spend time with him later. And so I like to have legislation that strengthens the family. And the family needs a home. We need good health, access to health care, and jobs. Somebody in the family has to work to provide. And we have transferred too much of that responsibility to the government. I like that the family takes more responsibility for that, and not that we rely on the government, especially with jobs. When you look at the homeless crisis and the homeless people downtown Portland, we talk about healthcare and put a roof over their head, but what about the jobs? That should be part of the treatment program. That's the goal, that you become a productive contributor to society. And then the pursuit of justice, I think is very important, not only in our judiciary, that we don't reward criminals, but punish criminals. I think it's very difficult to be a judge, to have good judgment. Not only to convict the criminal, but also not only let the innocent go free, but also to convict the criminal. You know, I had a judge once told me he was afraid to convict an innocent people, so in case of doubt, he let the person go free. But that's not justice to me. And the same in healthcare. I find we have too much focus on vaccines, on pharmaceuticals, and less so on medicine and health. Now, health and medicine, to me, are synonyms. Pharmaceuticals is something else. And vaccines within pharmaceuticals, that's why I think freedom of speech is so important among the professionals. We shouldn't pull a license when somebody disagrees, but the consumer, the patient should have options and get honest advice. So those are my three goals, public safety, constitutional rights, and the pursuit of justice.
What kind of legislation would you propose to deal with those issues?
Yeah, it's a team effort. The focus of the Democrats in the past 20 years has been more government. So my focus is less government. For instance, in education, we've made by an ill-conceived ballot measure, we made the governor of Oregon the CEO of public education. And what I'd like to see is that she submit a budget proposal for our education system, public education, detailed. And I like to put the emphasis on the frontline workers, teachers. You know, nowadays we have a lot of other people involved in education. I call them the middlemen. When I grew up, we had a teacher and a principal. That's it. So I like to empower the teachers, also give them more money, give them a budget for school supplies. Well, we have teachers that pay out of their own pocket. I applaud that, but that's to our shame. So in the Ways and Means Committee, I hope to be a part of that. And as a former banker, I like to just do line items. We don't pay for non-essential. I like to focus on the core curriculum, arithmetic, writing, reading, that when a person graduate, they can do the basic math. They can look at a paycheck and look at all the deductions that comes out of the paycheck. Where is it going? That they know something. I think and just defund non-essentials and put more money into the libraries. I think the libraries they're not appealing to me. We should make more appealing libraries that children would like to be there and get books and obtain knowledge. So that will be my goal.
What do you recommend to make Oregon's infrastructure and population more resilient to seismic, flood, and wildfire disasters?
Yeah, it's a good question. We don't want FEMA. We see that as a disaster. I would like to see local people involved, maybe the National Guard. Let Oregonians take care of their own natural disasters. We don't need somebody from Ohio being ahead of FEMA running a show here in Oregon. He doesn't know Oregon, but we have very competent people in the National Guard. I'd like to see more training for that, more preparedness for natural disasters, and have practice runs. There's a lot of information available, but I feel Oregon is very ill prepared. If we get an earthquake, I think I'm very concerned about civil unrest. And in Florida, the looters, it's just terrible. So I'd like to see the National Guard more involved and reduce the role of FEMA. I think FEMA, they serve a purpose for training, but in Florida and North Carolina, it's just shameful how our tax dollars are wasted on inaction. It's just, it's shameful to me.
Final question. We have about a minute left. Why should the voters of House District 34 vote for you?
Well, we have a dominant Democrat legislature and government in Oregon, and it's the last 20 years voters have gotten us. And unless we break the absolute majority of the Democrats in our government, we won't get any accountability. So I don't mind if you're a Democrat, but don't vote for a person that that is a symbol of the status quo. If you want improvement, you gotta vote for a few Republicans in Oregon. You may not like them, but you may not love them, but vote for them. So that would be my message.
John Verbeek is the Republican candidate for House District 34 in the Oregon Legislature. Mr. Verbeek, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Eric.
And voters, don't forget, your ballots are due by November 5th.
Video Voters Guide is a service of the League of Women Voters, a 100-plus-year-old nonpartisan organization that believes democracy depends on informed and active participation. For election and candidate information, be sure to visit our online site, vote411.org, before you mark your ballot. All candidates in contested races are invited. Some candidates choose not to participate.